No doubt, the king has gone to God, for sure. I'll be missing Jesse. At this time, let's bring out his training partners, John, Sarge, Allen, and Grant Higamonster.
Good evening, everybody. First of all, beautiful PowerPoint presentation. Thank you. That was awesome. Jesse Marunde. Never heard of Squim, Washington until I met him. You got anybody know where Squim is? See, yeah. Never heard of Squim, Washington, but he put that town on the map for sure. 2000, my wife and I flew to Spokane, drove to the Big Sky Strongest Man in Missoula, Montana, and that's where I first met Jesse Marunde. Funny story is, we flew to Spokane, and we drove to Missoula, and here comes this guy in this beat up pickup truck, and buzz cut, tall, skinny, like fierce goatee and stuff, and it was Jesse. So, we got to talking and meet him and stuff, and then, where are you staying? Oh, just crashed in the back of my truck. I was like, what? And he's got his dog, Jack. If anybody knows, I've ever seen his dog, Jack. Jack was this huge, like, American, what was he?
American Bulldog.
American Bulldog, which is a really huge dog with a head that's bigger than a basketball. And I was like, cool, bro. And what happens? Witness the beginning of one of the freakishly strong and athletic strongmen that the U.S. and the world has actually ever known. Kid won the Big Sky Strongest Man. And I think he got third. But you could tell, when you see somebody on the platform or in a strongman contest that they're gonna shock the world one day, and that's what Jesse was. The one thing I do miss about Jesse the most was that he would love to be challenged. If you tell him, no way you can load this 300-pound stone 20 times, he'll like, I'll bet you right now he'll do it, and he would stay there and prove you wrong and stuff. I used to train at this cold warehouse in Kent, Washington. If anybody familiar where IKEA is in the Seattle area, I couldn't find a place to store, you know, stuff, strongman stuff, stones, chains, and stuff like that. Wintertime is cold. Wintertime is like, you know, sometimes 30 degrees. And, you know, we'd have to work out there like 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. and stuff. And it's cold, you know. And Jesse came one time. We had a 694-pound tire. And Jesse said he was going to flip it 100 times around the warehouse. I was like, that is disgusting. I don't know why. And there was another lightweight pro named Adam Keep. He's currently stationed in Germany now in the Air Force from Lakewood. And he said, I'll do it with you. I'm like, go for it, bro. It's all you, you know. So basically, Jesse would flip a tire, and then Adam would flip a tire. Because, you know, 100 flips with almost a 700-pound tire is a ridiculous amount of lactic acid being built up, you know. Adam bowed out after like 64 reps. And Jesse finished the 100 flips, which is just mind-boggling. And that's one thing I learned from Jesse the most, is that even though we get these days when you don't feel, you know, into your workout, or, you know, you're scared of the challenge of like, I'm gonna pull this weight, or I can't do this event, that son of a bitch will always make sure and believe in you that you can do it. And I just want to make sure everybody knows that, whether it's powerlifting, whether it's strongman, CrossFit, whatever sport you do. I mean, Jesse would always make you believe that you can do it. He told me one time, I think he could front squat 500 pounds. I was like, whatever, you know. I was like, that's crazy, you know. And I was able to do it maybe just like under 2 years ago, you know, and it's hard as hell. And then he said, Higa, we're gonna do this 500 squat pound, you know, squats for 20 reps. You guys hear that 20 reps program? Some of you lifters know that. So we're gonna do this one day at the Gold's Gym in Renton, and you're supposed to do 20 rep squats, follow up with 20 reps of stiff leg deadlifts, and then some chest pullovers for 20 reps. For the lifters here, the chest pullovers is a breeze compared to blowing up your back with 20 reps of squats and then following up with some deadlifts. I mean, I could only do 500 for 16, and that was tough, you know, really tough. Probably one of the toughest things I've ever done. But he would still believe that, hey, you're going to do this one day, you know. I haven't personally done that, but I mean, I really doubted myself that I could even get 10. But, you know, he did it. And that was one of the best things I miss about Jesse. You know, so if anybody can, you know, just walk away from this, Jesse Marunde was one of the greatest strength athletes ever. But believe in anything you can do. Because he challenges me to this day. And there's not a day where I wish I could call him. And I still got his email on my phone, you know. He was the man, and I miss him. My family misses him. And when I feel like I can't pull anything or lift anything, I think about him, and that son of a gun always pulls through for me. So thank you very much for everyone that's, you know, given up this award for Jesse. We'll have Sarge here give a few words for him. Thank you.
My given Christian name is John Allen. I've become known as Sarge due to Jesse Marunde. I'm normally very well spoken, caring, highly disciplined, but being here tonight, seeing that PowerPoint, It's hard for me to be here and experience this, but I appreciate each and every one of you coming. I'd like to thank Todd and these fine people for expanding this Hall of Fame to include the strongmen. I believe with all my heart that Jesse deserves to be there. And I'm going to tell you something before I get the secret to his success, our success at Swim Crew to this day, and we live by this motto, hard work. That's the bottom line. Okay, Jesse had a thing about him. He could inspire anyone to do hard work. I mean, he talked me at 40 plus years old into squatting my body weight 98 repetitions one set. Who does that? You know, funny story how that started. Me and Jesse, we met in 2000. I started lifting weights when I was about 14 years old, back in Salina, Texas. I wanted to play football for a Class 2A state championship team. Because when Texas, if you don't play football, you ain't shit. I had one minor problem, though. I was about 4'11", 125 pounds as a freshman. Most of the guys I grew up with at that time, they were about 6'2", 245 pounds. But I wanted to play, and so I went down my 8th grade year, and I met with the coach in the summertime before 2 days started. He said, son, you got to get in the gym, you got to get in there now, and you got to start eating today. So I did. I showed up 2 times a day, and I continued lifting from the time I was 14 all the way up until this day. But there came a spot in my life when I got out of the Marine Corps about 2000, and I just kind of lost the passion. I still went to the gym, but I didn't have a purpose. I just went because it's what I did as a habit. And then I met Jesse one day, due to an employee that worked for me, said, hey, I want you to meet this guy. You know, you kind of lift a lot. He's a lifter. He's a good athlete. I want you to meet him. And not to be gay or anything, but me and Jesse, man, it was bromance, love at first sight. It was. Both of us were, I have the drive like no other, and Jesse had the ability like no other. And I asked him, well, what do you do? How do you lift? You want to lift? Let's try something. So we went out to his grandfather's farm. Yeah, in a barn. And scraped the chicken shit off the stones. Yeah. So we could lift them. And we lifted in the mud, and the snow, and the rain, and the sleet, and the sunshine, and whatever came our way. We never missed. And we always did hard work every time we were there. We did hard work. And it started paying off. The problem was Jesse was still kind of skinny at that point. So he needed to eat. So I took it upon myself to sponsor him simply by feeding him $500 worth of groceries a week. To make sure this boy could eat. Because we had a dream. Jesse said, I want to be the world's strongest man, Sarge. That's what I want to be. And I believed in him. And he believed in me. And we went at this together. And we started systematically. As sick as it was, we had a plan. Our first plan, believe it or not, was to chase down Phil Pfister and beat him. Anybody know who Phil Pfister is?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's right. We did that at Hawaii's Strongest Man. We finally beat down Phil Pfister. Then our next plan of attack was to chase down and beat down Mariusz Pustanowski. Hey, we were right there. 2005, we were second. We lost it in the stones of all things. Jesse was good at the stones. And I firmly believe that in 2006, we would have beat Mariusz. But the good Lord took Jesse from us because he had a higher purpose. And he needed a good, strong man and a strong oak tree in his corner in heaven. And, you know, if you're God, you're going to take the best. And that's what I believe this day. There's not a day goes by that I don't miss Jesse, that I don't think about Jesse, and I don't still wish he was here. But I don't question my Creator. I know it's for higher purpose. And the one thing that keeps me going every day is I know that someday that we will train again. And it will be a glorious squat day in heaven. And we're going to squat hard. And we're going to squat heavy. And we're going to squat for eternity. Because as Jesse always said, we just need to squat more. That's how we're going to win. Is by squatting more. And I think if you'll look at the crew, that the legacy that Jesse has left, the Swim Crew, he's blessed us in so many ways just by giving us that drive, giving us that motivation. He still blesses my life continuously, even to this day, by putting me here tonight in front of all you fine people. He's blessed me. I get to know my and be good friends with my childhood heroes, the likes of Bill Cashman, you know, Randall Strawson, you know. How does a plain guy like me from Salina, Texas, that was just a skinny little kid that wanted to play football, get through life and get to meet and be friends with all of his childhood idols? And that was a great gift that Jesse put upon me, and that was solely due to his abilities and his desire. And I owe everything in the strongman world that I have or ever accomplished and our crew's ever accomplished to Jesse. And thank you for listening to me blabber, and I apologize for being broke up about it, but it's just so near and dear to my heart that I just can't help it. And thank you.
Jesse Marunde into the 2012 Northwest Strength Athletes Hall of Fame.